United States Air Force Strategic Air Command weapon system. The SR-71, a highly sophisticated reconnaissance aircraft of the 60s, still ahead of the state-of-the-art in the 70s, was first announced in February 1964. The program was started initially with a systems project office given specialized management authority and answering directly to Air Force headquarters. As the program progressed, the specialized management authority was transferred to the present Advanced Systems Program Office with complete administrative, engineering, and logistics responsibility. A pattern now accepted for several key Department of Defense programs. The Lockheed Advanced Development Projects, nicknamed the Skunk Works since the early 40s, well known for its ability to produce in a tight security atmosphere, was selected to proceed with this highly sensitive program. A global reconnaissance system that would sustain altitudes above 80,000 feet at speeds beyond 2,000 miles per hour. With the experience gained on the YF-12 interceptor program, the task of producing the SR-71 was underway. The airframe and systems design was rapidly finalized. Engineering drawing release moved into high gear. Titanium, a light, high-temperature resistant metal, was selected to endure the torturous environment of triple sonic flight. A shop workforce, already skilled in working with titanium, was expanded as production tooling and assemblies take shape. Ship number one moved into final assembly. Soon, another milestone is reached. Maintaining tight security and under the cover of darkness, serial number 950 leaves the assembly plant. The convoy delivering the first airplane arrives at the flight test facility. This new member of the family of Blackbirds made its debut just 22 months after go-ahead. Production aircraft scheduled for evaluation soon arrived at Edwards Flight Test Center. Almost concurrently, Lockheed and Air Force flight test efforts proved the airplane and systems. Meanwhile, facilities at Beale Air Force Base in Northern California were being readied to receive SAC's new MACH 3 Plus aircraft. A new team was being formed. Members were arriving on base daily. The Lockheed ADP Field Engineering Support Group, formed early in the test program, arrived at the operational base, consisting of a small group of engineers, logistics and systems personnel. Equipped with fast response procedures, they brought the manufacturer's entire support as close as the commanding officer's telephone. The physiological support division was busy processing flight crews selected from the many highly qualified volunteers from throughout the Air Force. Personnel were scheduled into training. Animated aides familiarized students with the internal workings of the engine and system components. Functional aids utilizing actual airplane parts are used to develop operational and maintenance skills. Indoctrination with a spacesuit life support system required by the crew provides the newly assigned team members with first-hand information relating to the SR's hostile operating environment. Transition to the SR was rapidly being accomplished. With introduction to the flight simulator, the goal of flying the Blackbird is in sight. Flight crews experience the operation and performance of the airplane and reconnaissance systems in a realistic simulation of flight. Flight crew and maintenance training was proceeding on schedule. The all-important day is here. An anxiously awaited member of the team arrives on base. This first Blackbird received by the 9th Strategic Reconnaissance Wing was an SR-71B, a trainer. Enthusiastic team members are on hand to congratulate the commander and welcome the star performer. The pace quickens. Additional aircraft arrive. The new birds are on a busy flying schedule. Crews are eager to take to the skies. The SR's dagger-like shape is thrust through the sky by more power than 45 diesel locomotives. During flight, the cockpit remains comfortable, while just outside, airplane skin temperatures exceed a searing 600 degrees. The men flying this phenomenal machine soon were routinely flying Mach 3 and beyond. The team, proud of their bird and the crews that fly them, established an exclusive club. At an impressive ceremony, each crew member is awarded a Mach 3 Plus pin and certificate, honoring his first flight at 2,000 miles per hour. With the Blackbird came a new era of manned flight, introducing new requirements and procedures. The wing commander and his staff, ever mindful of SAC's goal, be ready on time, at any time, in any weather, finalize the details of a unique operational plan. The combined 9th Wing organizations work out procedures for putting the SR into service. The chief of maintenance, working closely with his flight line and shop personnel, continuously reviews and directs the progress of the team. An intimate knowledge of the mission equipment has been developed. Preparing the aircraft for flight is becoming second nature. Specialists working around the clock improve their maintenance skills. Transition to the new technology of the titanium bird is rapidly being accomplished by an enthusiastic team. VIPs, veteran pilots in command positions with a requirement to know the Blackbird, are scheduled for accelerated training. A thorough checkout in the simulator is the last phase before flight. With a 9th Wing instructor pilot, they board the aircraft. With a push forward on the throttles, they take to the air. experience, climaxed with an impressive red carpet ceremony, they too are now members of the exclusive club. The SR's two-man crew are assigned as a team during early flight training. A picture of an SR's flight crew would be age 30 to 35. Experienced in supersonic fighters, B-58s, B-52s, and high-altitude U-2s, with 2,500 to 4,000 flying hours. Proficiency milestones are rapidly being reached. Aerial refueling from a friendly tanker gives the Blackbird almost unlimited endurance. Global range training flights are now routine. Air crews working as a closely knit unit are rapidly approaching mission ready status. Operational readiness is near, all but the final exams. To the man, the ninth wing is ready. The inspection team arrives on base. The operational readiness inspection begins at once. During the ORI, every man, procedure, and piece of equipment is reviewed and tested. High-ranking personnel responsible for the wing deployment decision review the inspection scores. The 9th Strategic Reconnaissance Wing had passed its operational readiness inspection. A monumental leap has been accomplished. A global reconnaissance system that will sustain altitudes above 80,000 feet at speeds beyond 2,000 miles per hour is operationally ready. The SR-71, designed and manufactured by the Lockheed Aircraft Corporation, was delivered on schedule, within budget, and has met all its performance goals. It is supported by a responsive management system. The Strategic Air Command's 9th Strategic Reconnaissance Wing has flown thousands of hours at Mach 3. They have pioneered sustained operational flight above 80,000 feet at speeds beyond 2,000 miles per hour, carrying forward the tradition of unarmed reconnaissance. Living up to their motto, peace through surveillance, by providing information for the security of the United States and the free world. The SR-71 in a single flight has flown over 15,000 miles. On one mission, it is capable of mapping a section of the world equal to a path 60 miles wide from San Francisco to New York. The incredible Blackbirds and the team that operates them are justly proud guardians of peace through surveillance.